Well, here's a demonstration of how we could use Excel's data analysis feature to do a multiple regression. The data that I'm using here is the data that we used in the slideshow. Remember, we're trying to predict how much it would cost to heat a house based on the average outside temperature, the inches of insulation in the house, the age of the furnace, and whether or not it has a garage. And remember, whether or not it has a garage is a dummy variable. So I'm going to go ahead and collect data, and then data analysis. And I'm going to choose regression, and then OK. My y range, remember, is what I'm trying to predict. It is the dependent variable. So the dependent variable is cost, how much it's going to cost to heat the house. My x range will include all of them at this point, because I don't know which of these are significant predictors and which ones are not. So I'm going to include all of what I think might be the independent variables. I'm going to go ahead and use the 95% confidence level, or 0.05 significance level. We'll choose an output range here. Let's just throw it right here, an H2. We click OK, and there our data analysis is done. Now remember, after that, as the slideshow discussed, we want to look at the F. And of course, just looking at an F value is that high, I know at this point that I can reject the null hypothesis. The null hypothesis would be that none of these x variables are significant predictors. Well, I know by looking at the f that at least one is. So the next step is to look at either the p values or the t stats, as we discussed in the slideshow here. So once I've done that, and I can see that looks like there's a couple here that are significant predictors, but age, as we found out before, is not. So what I want to do is I want to run it without age. Well, the order that I have here would be a lot easier if age is somewhere else. So I'm just going to insert a row here, a column, excuse me, not a row, and I'm going to go ahead and move the garage over so that I can keep the variables that I want to run, the independent variables that I want to run in the analysis together. So I'll go ahead and run the analysis again, data analysis, regression. This time, same Y range, except the X range is going to stop at D, so I don't really have to change anything here, just except change the E to a D. I'm also going to change the output range. I don't want it to be here at H2. I'm going to go ahead and go down here, and at that point then I'm going to go ahead and click OK and run it again. This time we can see that we have p-values that are all pretty close to zero, at least all smaller than 0.05. We have t-stats that are higher than the 2.12 critical value. And so you can see that it's very, very, very easy to do multiple regression in Excel's data analysis.